Welcome to another video. It's me. My name is Jesse. I go by BAESD online everywhere. Today's a little bit of a different video, and I ran a little poll over on Instagram, and a lot of people want longer videos, so I'm gonna give you guys a little bit of a long video because these drawings took me a little while to finish, and I want you guys to see almost the full progress of how I did it. Anyways, you guys know I recently became addicted to Lego, so I went to the Lego store, got a bunch of these blind boxes, and I got this cool little three pack that they have displayed. You can just pick ones you want. Originally, my idea was to draw all of them, but the video turned out to be like 3 hours long. In this video, I'm only gonna do three. I'm gonna pick my favorite three and I'm just gonna draw those. And then if you guys wanna see a part two and me draw all the other ones, just comment on this video and say, hey, I wanna see the rest of them, man. And then I might have a couple more in the next video. All right, let's get into the yap season. You guys know I like to yap. Here we go, the yap starts now. Today, I wanted to talk about art style while I'm sitting here playing with my Legos that I'm actually using for character design inspiration, if you didn't know. I had a question for you guys to talk about in the comments, and I wanted to know how you got your art style and how do you feel about your art growth right now at this very exact moment. Before I get into how I found my art style, I wanted to talk about how I've been on a consistent art journey for about 6 years. I got my iPad in like 2018. This is all stuff I've talked about before. But even though I've been doing it for 6 years consistently, I feel like I don't have a consistent art style. I have a lot of favorite artists, and I just automatically know their art style. If I see it somewhere, I'm like, oh, I know that person did that. Like, for example, I had like a Fortnite loading screen. I immediately knew that was Kiptoe. So I went to his YouTube and his Instagram, and I searched up, and it turns out he did do it. And I was like, yeah, that's him. But like my art style, I feel like I don't have that yet. And I feel like every time I do a drawing, it's always different looking from the first one. When I try to imitate my own art style to keep it going, everything just ends up looking exactly the same as before. I get like the same shape of the head, same mouth, same face syndrome, basically. I just change the hair or the accessories, and it's getting kind of annoying. But I also think a big factor of this is that my art style is cartoony, and I want that cartoony art style because that's why I love to make cartoons. Ever since I applied at Marvel and they told me that they want more of like a realistic anatomy approach, kind of like the X-Men 97 vibes, I've been leaning more towards that kind of art style. So I think a little bit of my characters are kind of starting to change a bit, but not too much. They still have that little cartoony feel. Are any of you guys feeling what I'm feeling, where you're just looking at your art and it's like looking the same, like you're doing the same thing over and over again? I really wanted to be a character designer, so all my art was in three quarter view with just their arms down, not in no pose, because I was trying to do turnarounds, and that's my whole thing. Is like I just wanted to be a character designer, but now I'm finding out that character design is like the hardest thing to get into. From what I've learned, character design is basically you're designing the whole shows, and I don't feel like that's an entry level position for me. So I'm kind of steering away towards character design, but I still like drawing characters. So that's what I'm still going to do, because I still want to have characters for my own stories and creations and cartoons and worlds and all that, basically. So I'm leaning more towards like a story route after getting like tons of feedback. All these I've done a few portfolio reviews this year, and everybody's like suggesting I lean towards story. Everybody's suggesting that I get more into like storyboarding revisionists if I want to get into the animation industry, because it's more of like, they say there's more positions for like storyboard artists and storyboard revisionists and prop designers than there is character designers. I'm taking a class right now with Yuhki Demers, I believe is how you say his name. He's a viz dev for Sony. He said something about like character, there's only like two character designers where he worked, and they had like tons of positions for like viz dev and background designers and stuff like that. But that's what I keep hearing, like it's super hard to get into character design, so I'm kind of like leaning away from that. I'm still gonna make characters, but I think my portfolio is gonna be tailored more towards story stuff and prop design and all that, because I feel like that's gonna be my only way to get in, man. And then just do character design on the side, because I took a class with Steven Silver and he did some drawers for me, and he really helped me with my shape language and my line of action. Like I had a character who was like super stiff, and he went over, showed me the curve, the S curve or whatever, I forgot what they call it exactly, and then he redrew it, and it just like clicked in my head like what I was missing. So no, ever since I took that class, I feel like my characters like, even if they're just standing there, they're still kind of off to the side, like slanted a little bit, or more of a action-y pose, even though it's such like a steel pose. Like this character right here, I'm drawing this little skeleton dude. If you can tell, he's kind of like, his shoulders kind of off axis along with his hips, and he's like kind of in a heroic pose, instead of like if I post some of my old stuff where they're just standing there like stiff blocks and they have no character, no shape language. For this character, I wanted him to be like super skinny and a little bit of a human proportions, and I think I achieved that with this one. I'm getting there. My human proportions are getting there. Wouldn't you agree? now it's time for me to yap about art style. So my biggest top of the chart inspirations, everybody's probably, is Dragon Ball Z. I started on Dragon Ball Z. When I was younger, all my art looked like Dragon Ball Z. I just try to replicate it so bad. And then I saw Samurai Jack. To me, Samurai Jack had like the eyebrows and stuff like that that was like similar to Dragon Ball Z. So I took that and I would draw that all the time. Pokemon, and I would just like mash them all together and then try to draw my own characters. But I never really tried to focus on creating my own like art style without imitating anything until I got my iPad in 2018. Then I would always draw myself like skateboarding or something like that. And I was super inspired by Adventure Time and Steven Universe. And a lot of people say my stuff looks like Danny Phantom, which is cool because Danny Phantom to me also has a similarity to Dragon Ball Z because their eyes and eyebrows. I love drawing thick eyebrows. I love drawing big ears. That's just my thing. I don't know why I love it so much, but that's my cartoony side. If you look at my most recent Miles Morales drawing that I love right now, his proportions are not super cartoony. They're more in line with the movie. And that's because I talked about how I got that feedback from Marvel. And ever since then, I'm just like, my goal for this year is to make more analytically correct characters, if that's, did I say that right? Analytically correct proportioned characters. I'm on that art growth, so I'm pretty sure I will complete that goal. If you guys are on the same path, please let me know. I highly recommend taking any type of art class, Skillshare, 21 Draw. I just did Domestika right now, and I'm also on Underpaint right now. I'm just trying to absorb as much knowledge as I can, and I have so many books that I'm reading too, and I really want to like review these books for you guys so you guys know which ones you guys should dive into. Because if you're like me and you can't like absorb knowledge, like these books, I read them, didn't absorb nothing, so I'm reading them again and I'm taking notes, and then I'm actually gonna like draw along with them. That's one thing I didn't do, because I usually take them with me in the car and read them while I'm like waiting or something like that, so I don't do no drawing with the books, which is stupid because they're drawing books. Why wouldn't I draw? But I don't. But I'm gonna do that, and I'm gonna review this book that I'm reading right now because it's a really good book. It's highly recommended on like TikTok and stuff like that, so we'll talk about it. Back to art style. I keep going on these tangents. I'm just gonna tell you guys, a lot of people comment, a lot of people DM, what would they call my art style? How did I get my art style? Basically, just watch a lot of shows, imitate a lot of art styles, check out your favorite artists on Instagram, redraw a lot of the work. I have sketchbooks where I go to Instagram, I find my favorite artists, and I just redraw all their stuff in my sketchbooks. And I don't show those a lot because it's technically, it's not really my art. It's like I'm just imitating somebody. So whenever I do my next sketchbook tour, I think I have a few pieces where I redrew some of my favorite artists' stuff. When I post that, I'll definitely tag them and say where it's from, because I don't want to steal nobody's art. So if you're imitating people's art style, please tag them and give them credit. Don't take nobody's art, please. It's happened to me millions of times, and so many times where I don't even care no more. People would tag me all the time. Oh my god, just thinking about it right now, all the time people would tag me and say, this guy's stealing art, this guy's tracing art, and my art's bad. So that means their art's not gonna grow because they're tracing somebody's art that doesn't even know how to draw hands. Don't do it. Don't be that guy. But if you are that guy, just make sure you give credit, all right? So just look at your favorite artists, see what they're doing, look how they're doing their brush stroke, look how they're coloring, watch cartoons, watch movies, and just absorb all this stuff around you. Constantly just look at everything, break everything down in your head. I did a class at Concept Design Academy, and once I took that and they explained how to break stuff down, I start, whenever I watch something or I'm watching a cartoon or even movies, I look at shapes and like everything now, and I feel like I'm kind of like a mutant, like an X-Man. What would my X-Men name be? What would your X-Men name be if you're like an art mutant or something? I don't know, stupid question. But it leads me into my final thought, or my final like question for you guys. Do you guys feel like you've had an art growth this year so far? I know we're only like 3 or 4 months into the new year, but do you feel like you've changed anything about your art to where you feel like the last drawing that you did is better than the ones you've done before that? I feel like the last like 5 or 10 drawings I've done this year are way better than anything I've done in 2023. And I'm getting so much feedback now that the Instagram is growing. People are actually like taking time to look at my work and give me critique. Like I just did a portfolio review a couple days ago, and I actually got tons of critique on what I need to work on. Like my lighting is not that good, my composition's okay apparently. That's cool. I'm glad, because I feel like composition is something I need to work on. But I feel like I've gotten way better in the past 2-3 months than I did in the past year. So if you guys feel like you've grew, comment below, let me know what you guys think you've gotten better on. If you guys haven't grown, or you don't think you've grew, comment, let me know what you need to work on. If you guys want portfolio reviews, or if you guys want me to take a look at your guys' art in another video and give some critique, actual critique, like I won't sugarcoat it. I'll be like, you know what, this is ugly, because I hate that when people do that for me. Like, I'll ask for critique and they're just like, everything's good, this is good, that's good, that's good. I don't know why you're not in the animation industry yet. This is good, that's good. I get sick of hearing that, because clearly it's not good, because I'm not getting a lot of work. And then I look at my art and I know, like, this needs to be fixed, that needs to be fixed. Like, stuff I took to Lightbox last year is so ugly to me now, because I'm way better now, and I'm like, I can't believe I got this printed up and took it and gave it away as a portfolio. And it just grosses me out. Anyways, art growth. If you guys feel like you've grown, please comment below. If you feel like you haven't grown, please comment below. If you need any tips, please let me know in the comments. Shout out to all my Patreons. Thank you guys all for being here. This video is like 4 hours long, but I cut it down to this short video because I cut out so many yaps. I was yapping forever and I was just like, you know what? This has nothing to do with the video. Let me try to keep the parts that have something to do with the video. And I go off on some spots, but I try to bring it right back. But if you guys like this concept of video, if you guys want me to finish drawing the rest of the Lego characters, please let me know. Thank you guys for being here. Thank you guys for all the love. Please drop a like, sub, comment, whatever. I don't care. Do what you want. I'm not your mom. Just do what you want. Do what you want. Okay? Have a good one. Peace out. Bye. All right?